In this video, we're going to be looking at what is multiplication. To explore this question, let's start with an example. If I have 6 bags of cookies and each bag has 8 cookies in it, there are several ways to find out how many cookies I have in all. I could open all the bags and count them. That gives me 48 cookies. But what if I don't want to count out each cookie? I might not want to handle them. So, what am I going to do then? I know that there are 8 cookies in each bag, so I simply could add 8 6 times. So let's see, that's 8 plus 8 is 16, plus 8 more is 24, plus 8 more is 32, plus 8 more is 40, plus 8 more is 48. Okay, so 6 groups of 8 is 48. I have 48 cookies. This repeated addition works great, and it's a lot faster than counting them out individually. Let's take a closer look at what we did there. Instead of looking at the cookies one by one, we viewed them as 6 groups of 8 cookies each. We counted a set of things more effectively by organizing them into equal size groups. As you can probably guess, this type of situation comes up a lot. It is so useful, in fact, that we're going to introduce a new operation to describe it, multiplication. Multiplication is a shortcut way to talk about repeated addition. To write this, what we do is first write down the number of times we're going to repeat a number, then we'll put a multiplication symbol in, and then we'll write the number that we want repeated. The multiplication symbol can be written in several ways. I personally prefer the star symbol, so that's the one we'll be using. This new operation is closely related to addition, because one way to figure out what 6 times 8 is to add 8 6 times. But later we'll find even a faster and easier way to solve these sorts of problems. You might have noticed that when I counted out the cookies, I organized them into rows and columns. This is called an array. 6 groups with 8 elements in each group. So let's start by looking at some other examples. There are 5 people in our family, and I want to order enough pizza for each person to have 2 slices each. How many slices do I need? Well, I've got 2 groups of 5, which is 10. So 2 times 5 is 10, and I will need 10 slices of pizza. My kids like to spend a lot of time in the playroom, and I want to put down foam tiles. The room is 4 feet by 7 feet, and each tile is 1 foot square. So how many tiles do I need? Well, that would give me 4 groups of 7, which is 28. So 4 times 7 is 28, right? 28 tiles. We can always solve things by repeated addition, but sometimes those problems get quite large. So in the future, you'll probably memorize some of your basic multiplication facts, like 4 times 7, and then we'll use other ways or algorithms to solve larger multiplication problems.